Alright folks, in this video I'm going to show you how to set the tone arm on a vinyl turntable. Now first of all, make sure you've got your specific cartridge and stylo on the end of the actual tone arm itself. Secondly, small tip here, just make sure that you've got your finger underneath the actual cartridge at the ready. Now very quickly, by doing something like this, it will hopefully stop the actual needle, the stylo, from skipping. More importantly, it will prolong the life of your vinyl as well. Now the reason I've got my finger underneath here is because there's a good chance when I take the clip off the arm and then move this over away from the arm that the actual cartridge will drop. So you've got your finger at the ready so the needle doesn't bang against the actual turntable. Now what I need to do, I need to get this particular tone arm to float. So if I move the weight backwards, watch what happens. Can you see now the actual cartridge is going up and the actual weight is going down? What we need to do, we need to have it so it's flat. If you can see the way the pen is there, it's flat, exactly the same as the top of the actual turntable itself. Now we can do that by either moving the weight forwards or backwards. Always make sure that you've got your finger at the ready. So if I just move that back a little bit, forwards a tiny bit, I still need to go back a segment, back again, back a bit more, forwards, and let's have a look, back a bit. I mean, this will take a little bit of time, but it's well worth it. Right, there you go, that's near enough floating. Alright, we've got a dial here, it's got anti-skating on it. Now watch what happens if I move this anti-skating all the way to number 3. What happened then is the tone arm moved straight to the actual armrest. If I move it to the 0 position, it's now moving away from the actual armrest. Now what I need to do, I need to set the anti-skating so it's near enough staying still. Now you may find that you may not need to move the anti-skating at all. Now once we've got that set, with my finger on the actual weight at the back, I need to move this black dial to the 0 position, like so. Now that's at the 0 position. Okay, here's the deal now. Every single cartridge in Styli will have a different setting. Now on the box, you'll have maybe a weight of 2.5 grams or maybe 3 grams or 3.5 grams. Now that's where this guy here comes into play. Now what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to pause the camera and we'll have a closer look at this area. Alright, let's say hypothetically this cartridge was set for 2.5 grams. Now what I need to do then, I need to move this around to 2.5, like so. There you go. Right. Once you've got that set, it's just a matter then of setting the actual height adjustment. Now some turntables have got height adjustments, some haven't. What you generally find is, if I suppose you're a turntablist and you like cutting, scratching, that kind of thing, quite often it's a good idea maybe to have the actual arm itself so it's tipped very slightly. In other words, the weight is a little bit higher than the actual cartridge at the back. But let's say if you're just a general mixing DJ, then keep it straight and flat, exactly like that. So in other words, for a turntablist, maybe have the back lifted very slightly. For a normal DJ, a mixing DJ, have it flat like that. So there you go, a bit of an insight for you, and hopefully this will make sure that your needle isn't jumping all over the place and your vinyl lasts a little bit longer. Practice and enjoy.